The Elvis Cup Guy here. Quick video. Hey, check it out. This video is very special because I'm going to show you Michael Jordan's house. You've got to watch this entire video, but I promise this is not clickbait. You will see Michael Jordan's house. So watch this thing till the end. Also, there's some Elvis surprises in here and another little video clip about an odd connection I have with Michael Jordan. But when I knew him, he was Mike Jordan. So anyway, watch this whole video. Michael Jordan's house is coming up now, and I was there. So watch the whole video. Hey, y'all, it's Cup Guy here. Quick video. Check it out. I am here on Lake Norman, about 10 miles from Charlotte, North Carolina. And I am right across the little inlet here from Michael Jordan's house, lake house, here about 10 miles from Charlotte. And let me see if I can point to it. It's right over here. So it's facing that way. So the trees are kind of hiding part of it, but you can see his little pier and his gazebo. So anyway, that is Michael Jordan's house, lake house. And he currently still has that as an address. He still resides there legally. And, you know, I don't think he lives here all year, but of course he is the majority owner of the Charlotte Hornets, formerly known as the Charlotte Bobcats. Anyway, I'm gonna flip this camera around so you can see it a little better. All right, so a lot of it is obstructed by trees there, but you can see this thing right here. Hold on, let me get my, see if I can get that into focus. Yeah, there is the pier and the gazebo, and his house is right there behind those trees, but you can still see it right there. But it's behind those trees. You see part of it. There's a house beside of it. That's not his house. His house is right here, okay? From here to here, and there's the pier and the gazebo. So there you go. Michael Jordan's lake house is right there. So let me flip this camera back around. This is the Elvis Cup Guy showing you Michael Jordan's damn house. And just to show you where I am, I'm gonna flip the camera back around so you can get the scenic views of where I am right now. Undisclosed location, of course, but the Elvis Cup Guy is always bringing you weird, interesting, crazy, whatever bullshit. Check it out. I'm gonna pan around and let you see where I am. Of course, once again, Michael Jordan's lake house. And then I pan around and let me zoom out a little bit. Here's where I am right now. Check it out. Hear that water? Little waves. But anyway, I'm right here and Michael Jordan's house. So this is the Elvis Cup Guy. I'm out of here.
Hey, it's me, the Elvis Cup Guy. I'm thinking about doing a video about the time that I actually played basketball with Mike Jordan, or as people know him now as Michael Jordan. As you can see here, I went to Carolina Basketball School with Mike Jordan in 1980. And picture of Mike at basketball school. Letter I got from Carolina Basketball School, 1980. My plane ticket to go to Carolina Basketball School. Certificate from Dean Smith, 1980, Carolina Basketball School. Schedule. Michael Jordan's letter about basketball school, 1980. championship game that I played with him in 1980. So if there's enough interest, basketball again, if there's enough interest, I'll go into the story and do a video on it. So let me know.
Hey, Elvis Cup Guy again. One final note. This is Michael Jordan's lake house behind me here, right back here. And there's the pier and the gazebo. But this is the Elvis Cup Guy live. Well, when you see it, it won't be live. From right across the little waterway here from Michael Jordan's lake house right back here. Keep watching. There's more shit coming up. Hey, Elvis Cup Guy here. Hey, just want to check in with you guys. Keep watching. There's a lot more stuff on here. I just got done buying some groceries. I can't see it. Card because the damn sun's in my eyes. But anyway, keep watching. There's a lot more stuff on here. But I had to take a little break, get some groceries. But anyway, check it out. More on this vid. Hey, y'all, Scott Guy here. Check it out. 1978 450 SL Mercedes. I'm going to show it to you right now. But here it is in the background. But here we go. I'm going to turn the camera around so you guys can see it a little better up close. All right. 1978 Mercedes 450 SL. It does have a hard top, but it's not here on it. It's upstairs at this house. I came out here to look at it. But here's the engine. Okay. Of course, the iconic Mercedes emblem. And then I'm gonna open it up real quick so you guys can see inside. There it is, 1978. Mercedes 450 SL. Check that thing out. It's sweet, isn't it? Anyway, I'm sure a lot of you have never seen this kind of car before, or Mercedes on the particular model and year. But that's what she looks like. Here's the back. And I think I might do a little back angle. There it is. Isn't that sweet? Anyway, Elvis Cup Guy. Keep watching. There's more stuff on here, more crap, but I thought you guys would appreciate this thing. I'm out. Elvis Cup Guy here. Just want to give a quick shout out to DJ Phil 99 on eBay. You can look him up on eBay under the seller category, DJ Phil 99. He has always had all kinds of interesting Elvis stuff, mainly Elvis photos. Okay, but check it out. Hello, I'll read this to you in case you guys maybe have this on a phone or something, you can't read it. I saw in one of your YouTube videos you have a Kenny Wallace racing jumpsuit. I do. This autograph 8x10 photo of Kenny was in the personal collection of Elvis concert photographer Harold Newton, which I acquired back in 2009. See, I told you he has all kinds of Elvis photos, including the personal collection of Harold Newton. And if you are any kind of Elvis collector, fan, expert, you know that Harold Newton was a big deal. He acquired the collection back in 2009. Harold was a big NASCAR fan, especially with Kenny and Rusty Wallace. I enjoy your videos and thought you would like to have this in your collection. So he sent me this. Hold on, let me hold it up here so you can see it. A signed photo of Kenny Wallace, who is Rusty Wallace's brother. Now, you're wondering, why would he send me this? Well, I'm going to show you in a minute. It'll be a clip coming up. I have on a mannequin Kenny Wallace's racing fire suit in upstairs here in my Elvis Museum, and it's on a mannequin. So not only did he send me this signed photo, 8x10 photo of Kenny Wallace. Sorry for the reflection there of the light. But he also sent me a photo of J.D. Sumner, of J.D. Sumner and the Stamps Quartet, the night that I saw Elvis. This is a rare photo that Harold Newton took of just J.D. Sumner that night. So when I saw Elvis on February 21st, 1977, This is what J.D. Sumner looked like up close. Let me see if I can zoom in here a little bit. Yep, and you see he's got the TCB on. But I've never seen a photo that clear of J.D. Sumner from that night. I mean, you know, it's rare that somebody, especially Harold Newton, would take a photo of just J.D. Sumner, but he did. And I'm so thankful and grateful to DJ Phil 99, look him up on eBay, for sending me this cool photo of the night that I saw J.D. Sumner and the Stamps, and of course, Elvis Presley, February 21st, 1977, when I was 13. Thank you for this nice note you sent me. And of course, this Kenny Wallace signed 8x10. But hey, right after this, I mean, it just in just a couple seconds, you're going to see Kenny Wallace's race-worn, race-used fire suit on a damn mannequin up here in my Elvis Museum. So anyway, check out DJ Phil, and thanks again, DJ Phil 99, also known as Derek. Thank you, Derek, for sending this to me. That's really cool, and what a sweet picture of J.D. Sumner, the night that I got to see him, and Elvis, of course. Hey, I thought I would kind of turn the camera around and put this, the flash, or not the flash, but the light on, so you guys could see this Kenny Wallace race suit from, I think, around 2005. Some of you NASCAR fanatics, let me know. But anyway, here's the whole race suit. Okay. Oh, and for you guys that want to know what that is, that's when I went to Carolina Basketball School in 1980 and 1981. That's the ball, I think, from 1980, when I played basketball with and against Mike Jordan, better known now as Michael Jordan. But anyway, I might do another video on that. I have a video that I did on that, oh, I don't know, a year or two ago. You can look for it. But anyway, here is the Kenny Wallace race suit. His sponsor at the time was Stacker 2. Full race suit. And I've got even the, hold on, let me see. Another little thing underneath here. Like a fire suit kind of covering long sleeve thing. But anyway, it's really cool. But I want to thank DJ Phil 99 for sending me that rare 4x6 photo of J.D. Sumner. Just a photo of him now at the February 21st, 1977 concert at the Charlotte Coliseum that I went to, and I saw Elvis and J.D. Sumner and the Stamps and the TCB band and Joe Gershio Orchestra and Jackie Kahane, all those guys. But anyway, I want to thank you, DJ Phil, for sending me that photo and sending me the signed photograph of Kenny Wallace, because you had seen in one of my videos that I actually did own and have Kenny Wallace's racing suit on a mannequin upstairs here in my secret Elvis hidden museum. So anyway, there you go. There it is. Thank you once again, DJ Phil 99.
So the Elvis Cup guy and Jenny Presley want to say thank you. Thank you very much. God bless you. I hope you enjoy the channel.